Hey, what's happening, guys? In this video, we'll showcase an insane and powerful Ungabunga build variant with the perfect fusion of strength and radiance. Using the best of both stats, you will have at your fingertips a brute force beast when fighting all kinds of enemies in Lords of the Fallen, delivering massive damage and unmatched survivability. Perfect match to dominate NG Plus and beyond. I'll break down how to set it up from stats, weapons, armor, and spells, all the good stuff you need to become that unstoppable force of pain. So gear up and game on. So taking the power of Radiance in Lords of the Fallen with the raw damage that strength provides, this combination is a recipe for powerful hits with your weapons. Smite status effect, posture damage, offensive and defensive supporting spells, and great survivability, triggered by your attack. It's weird, right? But like they say, the best defense is a good offense. This build uses two big heavy weapons with medium to heavy armor to stay within medium encumbrance. Your attacks are not going to be that quick, but deal massive damage that can kill in just one swing. Your main stat is going to be strength and then radiance. Those are your main point investments because the weapons of this build have strength requirements and they're all about physical damage combined with holy damage. Since this is an NG Plus build, it's important to have vitality and endurance because the enemy difficulty avoiding get one shot and the amount of stamina needed to swing those two weapons. If you're not in NG Plus, don't worry, you can create this build and follow the stats ratio that I have on the screen to get strength to the final soft cap value and radiance close to the first soft cap and vitality past the second soft cap and endurance past the first cap. That's what I use. For this build, the class you want to use is one with strength and radiance. So the ones I recommend are Dark Crusader, Hall of Night, and Condemn that can become anything. And maybe Orion Preacher, but you have to invest in strength and endurance a bit more. For the build showcase, I'm using a Condemn in NG+. The first weapon I'm running with is the Iron Wayfarer's Hammer that scales S with strength and D with all the rest of the main stat and max level. Also has a huge attack power with the majority being physical damage, with a bit of holy and fire and wither damage. You can find it in Upple Calrath when defeating the Iron Wayfarer boss at the gates of Brami's castle. The runes I'm using with these weapons are two rooks, increasing the posture damage on enemies, and the last one depends on your playstyle. If you want to increase physical damage even more with the Perky Axe rune, or increase damage to enemy poised with the Scave, or gain health when striking an enemy with the Sabino, or just want to gain mana upon killing enemies to have the most mana possible all the time to cast Radiant Weapon and other spells. The second weapon is the one and only Justice, a grand sword that at max level scales A+ with strength and D with radiance. It has a whopping 200 smite buildup. It does great physical attack power as well as holy damage. To get it, you gotta go to the Sunless Gain Mines Vestige and go this route after this shortcut. And then keep going and you'll end up in the Hoist Vestige. Now you have to get to the elevator and get this route. Still go down this route and watch out for the archers. Go down the stairs and this is a shortcut. Keep going straight ahead, and this is the area where the Justice is. The runes I'm using on these weapons are one Crafter Essence to eliminate the weapon's requirement so we don't end up in the heavy encumbrance while wielding two grand weapons and armor, one Rook to increase the posture damage, and one Status to increase the holy damage. This last one can be changed to an Artem if you want to gain mana when killing enemies. The moveset while using both grand weapons are great and awesome to watch. You have a standing 1-2 swing light attack, a standing heavy attack smash, a running 1-2 swing light attack, a running heavy attack that can send enemies up in the air, L1 plus R2 that does both the smash and then the slash swing, and the heavy charge attack that is going to be really important for damage and survivability. So to have even more survivability with this build, you need to have the Umbral Eye of Loge as your primary eye in your lamp, and while charging your heavy attack, you won't be interrupted, so all damage received is granted as wither damage, so if you land a heavy attack, you will get that health back. Even with the recent nerf, it's still very powerful, so for tough enemies, the heavy charge attack is the way to go. To get it, you gotta go to the Path of Devotion Memorial and go down this route, and there will be enemies on the way. So we're going on the right, and you gotta go to Umbral, and you gotta Soul Flay here to get the Umbral Eye of Loche. The secondary eye I'm using is the Umbral Eye of Betrayed Iliad that gives plus 25% healing efficiency while in Umbral, and the Umbral Eye of the Bloody Pilgrim that regains 50% withered health upon striking an enemy while in Umbral. So the catalyst I'm using in this build is the Exactor Scripture that scales S with Radiance. It has 5 spell slots and is considered one of the top Radiant Catalysts, if not the best, outclassing all other Radiant Catalysts. You can get it for completing the pain in the ass Exactor Dunmire questline. The spells are a very critical and important part of this build, from offense to defense and support, with 5 spell slots that the Exactor Scripture gives, and can have varied options at your disposal. Let's start with the most important spell, the one you need to have up most of the time to maximize your damage and increase that posture damage. It's the Radiant Weapon that will add radiance to both Justice and the Iron Wayfarer Hammer. The next spell is Sanctify that will create a surround sigil on the ground that heals and cleanses any status effect. It is very helpful when you want to fight enemies in place. Next is the Aura of Tenacity, one of the support spells that will reduce the damage taken at the expense of 3 mana per second until you are depleted. Next is Invigorating Aura that will heal you and nearby allies at the expense of 3 mana per second until you are depleted. This will stack with Aura of Tenacity, so if you want to have full on defense and healing, you can pop up both auras. But in order to reduce the mana expense, you can use the Mana Stone Ring and the runes on the weapon that gives you mana or even the mana stone consumable. And the last spell is the Aureus Judgment that will summon bolts of radiant from the sky, damaging enemies. It's very useful if you need an extra damage push for crowded areas or tight rooms to clear them with ease. So when planning the build, I wanted an Oonga Boonga big weapon and big heavy and bulky armor. So I decided to go with the Jadale armor set that is raw and troubled giant design was very cool. I'm using the skull helm, the bone armor, the bone gloves, and trousers. And with this set, I end up still in medium encumbrance. For the pendant, I'm using the Hollow Triptych, and any holy damage you do will deal additional posture damage. That's why you need to use the Radiant Weapon spell often to get the best out of this pendant. It can be found in Mans of the Hollow Brothers. Now the first ring of this build, this is the Orion and Sorceress Ring that will increase holy damage. It can be bought from Stummen when he is in the Abbey of the Hollow Sisters and has his inventory expanded. The second ring depends on the fight I'm in, and it will depend on your playstyle, of course, but for regular enemies, I run with Melchior's Ring that will deal additional physical damage. Other options when I'm in a boss fight and want to increase my stamina or my mana regen is the Mine Owner's Ring or the Mana Stone Ring. So this build works great in NG Plus with some of the pieces obtainable at endgame. It combines the great power of Radiance and the damage of strength weapons to the point that it can kill from one swing, and the survivability is unmatched. If you get damaged while charging your heavy attack, you can get that health back. You can heal and decrease the damage taken with your spells. So in my preference, the attacks might be a little slow, but while it lacks on speed, it excels on damage, so I consider this to be an S tier hybrid build that you need to try it out in your next playthrough. So guys, hope you enjoyed this video like I did making it and playing it. If you run a similar build or different items, please post it down below. I'm very interested to read your comments. If you want to help the channel, hit that like button so this video can get to more people. And if you don't want to miss future videos of Lord of the Fallen, just subscribe to the channel and be part of the tribe. Thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate every one of you. And as always, be safe and see you on the next one. Ciao!